My name's Ryan, and I'm here to show you how we inspect the jet unit in Hamilton County. Again, we begin with the lids and risers. Note that most of the lids are intact. However, it comes a second motor lid. And we'll note deterioration on the outer edge. This deterioration, while not impacting treatment or at this time presenting a safety hazard, may likely need to be addressed in the coming years. As a result, we would note it and make the homeowner aware that there is a problem or could be a problem in the future. We also note that the risers, not only are they intact, but that they're sufficiently above grade level. This one is the only one with sufficient clearance on this system to prevent surface infiltration and runoff. The rest, as you can see, by the water pooled around them, are not high enough to allow proper surface runoff to be diverted away from the system. Later on, we'll look inside the tanks and see the extra water that has been diverted inside and how this may take away from the treatment capacity of the system. Beginning the inspection on the jet aeration system, we begin with the trash compartment. The trash compartment is where all waste produced in the house, be it from faucets, toilets, the washing machine, ends up. In this compartment, sedimentation occurs. This is the settling of solid waste away from the liquid product, which will be treated and then discharged from the system. The bottom layer, the sludge, is anything heavy enough to sink to the bottom. The middle layer, the effluent layer, is the liquid that we want to continue on through the treatment process. And the upper layer, the scum, is anything lighter than water, typically consisting of fats, oils, and greases, that again is kept in this compartment of the tank. By means of a baffle, a concrete structure that goes down below the scum layer, effluent water will pass up and into the next compartment of the tank, which is the aeration compartment. The aeration compartment houses the motor. The motor injects oxygen directly into the liquid, which feeds aerobic bacteria that make up the bulk of the treatment in the jet system. Once this motor is done cycling, again, by means of a wall and baffle, water passes, as it's been treated, into the clarifier compartment. The clarifier compartment is the last chance that solid waste has to settle out before making its way to further treatment, in this case, the upflow filter. Again, by means of a baffle, solid waste is kept in the tank, allowing water to move up and out to the final stage of treatment. In this case, the upflow filter, which accepts treated effluent from the main tank, channels water in directly to the bottom, and then allows it to filter up through gravel banks on two sides of the tank. Once this has been filtered, water is discharged, sometimes through a chlorinator, but not always, to the discharge line. Also take note of the vegetation around the system. Vegetation in close proximity, while not necessarily a problem, can impede inspector progress, maintenance worker progress, anyone who might need to service the tank, and if dense enough, the root network can create problems. As roots seek water, the tank is full of this and provides nutrients. Roots that get into tanks have the risk of damaging the concrete and many treatment components. Starting at the top of the trash compartment, we again inspect the risers and lids for proper integrity, ensuring that the risers are above grade level. In this scenario, we show that the riser is not above grade level. Note the amount of moisture around the top of the tank. Looking inward, we can actually see and hear water still running into the tank. This poses a problem as it allows extra water, which takes away from the treatment capacity, to push waste through the system before it has a chance to properly treat. Moving beyond that, we note the risers are in proper shape. There is no shifting, as indicated by a straight column directly into the tank. And at this time, there is no scum buildup. We do, however, see liquid effluent. This will be moved into the aeration compartment by means of the baffle, which cannot be seen at this time by this access. Moving to the aeration chamber of the jet tank, water has been separated from solid waste in the trash compartment and has moved through the baffle into this chamber. The motor, as we can see from the top, again, taking care to note proper riser integrity and a lack of shifting, we see that the motor sits down and closer to the waste than on other systems. This motor works by drawing air from the top and injecting it directly into the water by means of a shaft and impeller. When the motor is running, you will see turbulence and a rapid spinning. If you see spinning but no turbulence, the motor may not be aerating properly, which may indicate an issue with the aspirator tip or that it needs to have the air shaft cleaned out. At this time, the motor is not running. We would check the temperature to see if it is warm, indicating that it is on the off cycle,
or if it is cold, that it perhaps has not been running proper cycles or may need to be reset or repaired.
Moving on to the clarifier compartment of the jet aeration tank, we begin again with the lids and risers. The lid, properly intact. The risers themselves, properly intact. No shifting or cracking can be noted. However, we note that the riser itself is not sufficiently above grade level to prevent surface water runoff. We can see inside the tank itself the buildup of water and the pooling of water on certain concrete structures. This indicates that the water is not being diverted away from the tank and is actually being funneled into this compartment. Problems that arise from this are diminished treatment capacity by the tank as extra water is added to the system. Moving inside, again, checking the risers for smoothness, no shifting, cracking, or deterioration, we first examine the baffle, which in this case is made of concrete. The concrete structure, or PVC in some cases, is designed to keep solid waste in this chamber of the tank and allow only the passage of wastewater that has been treated through to the upflow filter. We look on this side, seeing an effluent layer that has been treated. In some cases, there may be a buildup of scum, which is normal in this compartment of the tank, again, being kept from discharging by means of the baffle. The generation tank is shaped such that the wall goes straight down on the outlet side and is angled back. The purpose of this, though we cannot see it, is to allow heavier waste to settle and slide back toward the aeration compartment, which allows for continued circulation and treatment of waste that has not been sufficiently broken down. Again, we are looking for lack of odor, any sort of buildup of incorrect or untreated material, and ensure that the water leaving the tank has been treated to the full extent. Moving to the last component that treats in the jet system, we find the upflow filter. Water has been treated by the aerator, solid matter has been kept in by the clarifier, and now liquid passes to the upflow filter by means of a connecting pipe. This upflow filter is a separate tank from the rest of the jet aeration system. Beginning from the top, we note the lids and the risers, again checking for any cracks or deterioration that may pose damage risks or safety risks. We note that the lid and risers themselves are not sufficiently above grade level to prevent surface runoff from infiltrating the tank. You can see the moisture on the outside here. Moving inward, we see that the risers themselves are intact, have not shifted, and do not experience any cracking at this time. Once water enters the upflow filter, it is channeled to the bottom of the tank by means of this trough. We'll note that this trough, made out of concrete, sometimes PVC, is in excellent shape, and that the water level is the same as on the outside. This is important and will be explained later. As water is channeled in to the bottom by means of an access shaft at the very edge of the trough, water is channeled to the bottom and spread out to the left and the right banks. The left and right banks have an opening of 6 to 8 inches from the floor of the tank, the very bottom of the tank. Above this, there is grating, which is steel-reinforced concrete, and pea gravel on top of that. These two elements will act as the actual filtration, which solid waste is left deposited on as treated water leaves the tank. Note treated water on the left and right banks, then moves through the notches to the discharge line. This discharge should be clear, odorless, as it is the final treated product that will move to the discharge line. A difference of liquid level in the upflow filter between the interior trough and the exterior banks may indicate that water is not flowing through the gravel filter as quickly as necessary. This may indicate time for a pump and will be indicated by an increased liquid level or raised liquid level inside the trough, sometimes bypassing by means of these notches. If the water is bypassing through these notches, that is a sure sign that it is time for the tank to be cleaned.